I'm now in my final week before I leave Antarctica. So I've been here for about a month so far. I've got another week to go. Spending 5 weeks in Antarctica is a lot for the average person, but I've had such an amazing, amazing time. I truly mean that. It's been above and beyond what I could have imagined and how much I enjoyed it here. So I'm having some conflicting emotions, really wanting to get home, but also really going to miss all of the community and people and amazing, amazing sights that I've seen here. My lab, as you can see behind me, is a bit of a mess right now because I am trying to get in as much microscopy as I can, trying to film all the little creepy crawly critters that are microscopic under my microscopes before I leave. And yeah, so it's going to be a busy week.
It's about 5 in the morning and I am extremely tired, but I'm about to do something very awesome. I'm about to go join a team that is drilling into the sea ice here around McMurdo in Antarctica. And they are drilling into the sea ice to put a underwater robot into it and drive it around, which is just amazing. It's really cool, not only for Antarctic research, but also this robot could be incredibly useful for exploring other worlds in our solar system, perhaps the icy moons of Europa or Enceladus. So it's really exciting to see a robot in action here in Antarctica that might be helping the future of space exploration. So let's go check it out.
Happens when you're a real serious nerd.
It's a crack! I gotta stop and take pictures of it!
Europa. The ice on Europa and the ice here are very different things, but they still have in common that there's kind of a stress field that's changing on a pretty regular basis. And so the crack I just stopped and took a picture of is looks like one of the things that people have thought, you know, happen in these tidal environments. It's one of the things that we'd like to understand better for this planet as well as for the outer solar system.
After driving out onto the sea ice for a couple of hours, we arrived at the Erebus Glacier Tongue, a 7-mile expanse where the glacier extends into the sea. The team got to setting up the robot, known as IceFin, with its array of environmental sensors, as well as a mission control center inside a tent. Before IceFin launched under the ice, we sent down a plankton net so I could grab some microbes to film.
Yeah, that's like Antarctica.
Seafloor and pizza.
Seriously spooky.
They love the real answer.
But that's a cool looking thing.
Oh, chili?
Actually, the rock is not in it.
Oh, there's
another one. Oh, tons of them.
There are way more crinoids over here.
I love these little squiggle guys.
Yeah, those are pretty cool. I wonder why they squiggle so much.
Little crinoid. Small. Little baby crinoid.
I'm looking for
there you
the.
Go, Justin.
That one looks kind of like one.
Is that a seal or a fish?
This is just awesome. Oh, is that a ghost shark? No.
That's
a fish.
That was a really great fish shot.
After getting to experience the glory of the life under the ice with the ice fin team, the next day I went on a pressure ridge hike to appreciate the sea ice itself. Pressure ridges are places where pieces of the sea ice cracked, separated, and then collided back together because of wind or currents, creating beautiful natural ice sculptures.
One of the things I got to do today was actually go over to Scott Base, which is the New Zealand base that's actually right next to the United States base here in McMurdo. You can only go by invite only, and so we were invited to dinner and we got to have tea and check out the New Zealand Scott Base, which seems much more modern compared to McMurdo, but it's very much smaller. So McMurdo has around 800 people in it right now, and New Zealand Scott Base has about 80 people in it right now. So big difference.
That's an angry penguin.
That apparently is an angry penguin. That's a distressed penguin.
So you've got to look for the.
Yeah.
Got it.
Maybe penguins are just not very expressive.
One of the benefits of Scott Base, though, is that they have ice cream. There is no proper ice cream here in McMurdo, or at least not if you want cream in it. But they had real ice cream at the New Zealand base, which was definitely a delight. It's the small things. This experience is like nothing else, both the actual nature of Antarctica and actually getting to see what it's like here, but also the community here. There's so many awesome humans that come to Antarctica, and the friendliness and hospitality that they've shown has been something that I will never forget. But really, overall, this trip has been as amazing, I think more amazing than I could have imagined, and I just appreciated the privilege and honor, really, to be able to come down here and experience it and get to share it with all of you.
After 5 weeks in Antarctica, I packed up my gear and microbes to board a C-130 for the 8.5-hour plane ride home. Upon landing back in New Zealand, my first reaction was the wonderful enjoyment of being able to smell plants in the air again. Thanks so much for joining me on my expedition to Antarctica. You can support this expedition and my ongoing Antarctic work by joining my Patreon. Thanks to all my patrons, and a special shout out to the ones listed in the YouTube description below. You're amazing. Also, thanks to the National Science Foundation Antarctic Artists and Writers Program, the San Francisco Microscopical Society, National Geographic, and the many Antarctic researchers, friends, and colleagues who helped me make this expedition happen.
Thanks so much for tuning in, Space Friends, and I can't wait to see you all, not in Antarctica, but in the rest of the world.